Subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon and never miss an update from Latestly.
So, भक्ति या भ्रष्टाचार, आस्था या अपराध, क्या है आश्रम की कहानी? Joining me now on Latestly, Bobby Deol and of course Aditi Bhavankar. Thank you so much for joining me on Latestly and we are talking about Ashram. I was just telling Aditi that the posters are, you know, everywhere. I was just driving down, you know, Bandra, down the promenade and I'm seeing Bobby everywhere. and I'm really glad to see you after a long time all over.
I know.
What does it feel like?
Even I'm dying to go for a drive and seeing all the banners. I haven't stepped out of the house. So maybe once I finish doing all the interviews, as you've already counted them, I will finally, when I finish, go for a drive and take my kids because it makes me really happy. You know, every actor, especially for me, I've been in this industry for 25 years and I've seen the ups and downs and to now finally get so much appreciation for my work from Class of 83 to now Ashram, the look of Ashram in the trailers has been really appreciated by people. They're all being fascinated by the way I look in it. So it's very encouraging and I feel very, 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 you know, it's the beginning of my achievements, which I'm hoping that I keep achieving more and more and entertain my fans and make newer fans. So really happy today.
Every time your new film comes up now, I mean, everything is dropped down featuring you, be it a movie or a web series. They're saying comeback of Bobby. Are you tired of the terminology, Bobby Deol?
See, as long as they take my name in the same breath, it's okay for me. Because at least they're thinking about me. And, you know, for an actor, it's always, every movie is a comeback. Because every weekend would be your, you know, the result. And either you make it or you break it. And I think... definitely for me, as I've had so many ups and downs, and finally people have started to appreciate it. Not finally, they've always appreciated my early works. I have done some, I've been part of movies which are big blockbusters, and I've been very, I mean, I've always had the love of my fans. I mean, it's their love that gives me the strength to go on, you know. And so I don't feel bad. I just feel that, yes, I'm going to come back every time I'll come back, and I'll try to entertain you.
You know what, Bobby, your character really in this show does not need any explanation. So I'm going to, you know, stick to Aditi only. Tell us about your character, Aditi. I mean, what are you doing in this one? Tell us about how do you take the story forward?
Well, I think I'm taking the story forward through Bobby and I'm the whistleblower. So I think being a wrestler and being doing what I'm doing in the show, I again I'm saying, is a very courageous act of the girl who did it, or I mean the character who did it. And I always felt it that, oh my God, look at this girl. I always felt it like she was walking hand in hand with me in those lanes of Ayodhya when we were there, you know, together, because I saw each and every girl over there who was a wrestler. And I still remember there was a time when I had to literally spit out a kind of a bhashan, a dialogue tha jahan pe main ek kisi cheez ke bare mein baat karti hu bahut tivrata se, aur us cheez se samne jo ladkiyan baithi thi sach ki wrestlers jo thi, they were crying and I was like, wow, you know what, after this I don't care what happens about
you,
me.
You made an impact, right?
I have my audience right here. I mean, ye to stage ban gaya mere liye. So you know, that kind of impact when a character gets you, forget me as an actor, this character is that strong. And I'm so happy and glad that Prakash Jha thought of me. Matlab wo mujhe jante nahi the personally, but audition dekhe jo unhone mujhe cast kiya hai, I think very rarely, because after doing watching She, nobody will think ki main ye kar paungi abhi immediately, you know. Where she's like a very innocent small little small town ki choti si matlab soch wali ladki jiski soch choti nahi hai, in fact soch badi udaan ki soch hai uski, but her this thing is very small and very, you know, kind of loving her brother, her parents and her small little dream of, you know, becoming a champion and to working hard towards it. Aur uske chakkar mein what happens eventually, and it's like a snakes and ladder kind of a game where, you know, absolutely, sometimes she's on top and sometimes Baba is on top, and then they're like, you know, together fighting this out. So I think it's like a very exciting,
all are waiting to see how the drama unfolds. But I must ask you this, why this debate is on about science versus spirituality, spirituality versus supernatural phenomena, what your personal beliefs are like. Let's start with Bobby Deol. What your personal beliefs are like? Where do you stand?
My beliefs are what I have learned from my parents. Because I believe that they are my everything. भगवान है वो मेरे लिए और जो उन्होंने मुझे सिखाया बचपन से लेके आज तक उससे मुझे मेरी समझ बनी है और मैं यही कहता हूँ कि that you have to believe in yourself. The society will always try to influence you, but if you have faith in yourself, the society can't take you on the wrong path. You know? And that's my belief. And so basically, this movie is all about. In our society, it's a fiction basically, and it's been influenced by the society. You know, every movie, every web series is influenced by what's happening in the society. So it's also based on that. And Prakash is always taken into matter storylines, which influence him, and he wants to make people see it visually and give them awareness about it. So here I play a con man, and con men are the ones, not in just in the spiritual sense, but they're con men in every field. You know, and you get, and we are, majority of the people are blind when it comes to faith. They are so innocent that all these con men in any particular stage of your life or any kind of life your life is, they come in your way and they use you. And so this basically Ashram is all about trying to make awareness about all these kind of people, the criminal people. And so that's why all these questions are arising about the ones you just asked. And for me, my father and my mother are my everything. So that's how where lovely. I get all my...
How lovely. How genuine. Aditi, what is your take on the whole issue, on the whole debate?
I'm not really... I'm not somebody who believes as such in anything other than the divine power, because I feel it. I see it through creation. I see it through people. And when it doesn't, we are all actually vibrating on a frequency. So if that frequency matches, you feel good. If it doesn't matches, you feel bad. And I think that is what is God, because eventually it's science and spirituality are sides of the same coin. So where do you tap on? You tap onto science, you get what spirituality is. And when you tap onto spirituality, you get what science is. So if it doesn't make sense to you in that way, then you are in a con game. And you got to understand that, because we all are very intelligent. We just shut ourselves. So this message, which Prakashja also, I think this is what he's trying to convey since the very beginning, you know. He's telling everybody, wake up, you know, don't be ki meko ye karna padta hai, kyunki society karti hai. Ye bhi ek society ka bhaag hai, aur hum bhi society ke hi bhaag hai. But then you don't have to bow down to that. You can use your mind, you can use your intelligence, and satyagraha karne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. You can go step by step in your own life and change things. People will automatically follow.
Absolutely. Everything is energy vibrating at a certain frequency. So tell us what the energy was like on the sets. All of you were on the same page right from the word go?
100%.
Yeah, I mean, it always starts off on the first day. Everybody doesn't know each other so well. I mean, I did meet Aditi at Prakashji's office, but still, you know, the familiarity only comes once you start working with each other. And I think it was a big... it was like being in a big family. It was, we all stayed on the same floor, and every evening we used to sit together, try to eat dinner together. And Prakashji used to always get these lovely desserts from Bihar, like khaja was one of the very most tastiest things. And so it was just fun. And we've worked all, I mean, Aditi and me have been a part of this big cast, which is so amazing. I mean, each and every one of them. There's so many of them, I won't be able to take everybody's names, but like Chandan, Darshan, Sachin, Tushar, Vikram, Tanmay, you know, there's so many of us. there's Tridha, and there's Parimita, and there is Anukrita, and there's so many of us, you know, but everybody was like evenings, you know, by the time we reached the 10, 15 day, we were all getting to know each other. And it was so nice because all of them have done such a great job that that's what Ashram is all about. You know, I mean, it's just imagine Prakashji saying that himself to us, that, you know, he was so happy that he had all of us to be a part of this web series, and he's enjoyed everybody's work and dedication. So I'm just hoping now that when you all watch it on the 28th on MX Player, which is free, which is a free app. You have to just download the app and watch it.
Though it's a fictional tale, Bobby, I mean, the identity marker, so to speak, the reference point is clearly certain activities that we see in this drama. Was a reference point, was the image for a role model, so to speak, for this one, for your character? Was it Baba Ram Rahim?
No. Nothing like that. There's no Baba or anyone that has been, it's been based on. It's basically a script which has been given to us. And Prakashji, the first day he himself told us, at least me, that just follow the script. This is your guideline. It's a fiction. We're just trying to portray the characters who are criminals and who are con men. And the good people who are there and how this con man has influenced their lives, that you have to keep in your mind. And that's it. And every human being has good and bad in them. It's how good we are at keeping the bad suppressed inside us makes us a better person. So when I was performing as the character, I just let the bad out and feel those emotions, feel the greed of the character and portray the character.
So here's my last question to both of you. Bobby, you said quite remarkably in the press conference yesterday that you waited for nearly 25 years to work with Prakashji.
Yes.
And quite a journey you have had. You have had your shares of ups and downs. But now that you have bounced back and you quite remarkably said that Bollywood is such a phenomenal industry. It is not what it is as it is portrayed in the media these days, with nepotism and you know, possible murders and suicides going on. You said it's a remarkable industry. It's a fantastic industry to work in. But there are challenges as well. It's not an easy ride. You have to sustain yourself with your craft and with your talent. What the challenges were like for you?
Like everybody goes through, you know, like I'm an insider, but my father was an outsider once upon a time. He ran away from home, struggled for so many years to become an actor, and finally achieved what he did. And he's a legend in the industry. And he did that because he never gave up. So I just believe that your hard work will turn into luck. You know, we always think about, we are not lucky. And I did that for a couple of years in my life, where I started getting upset and blaming others and self-pitying myself. And once I realized that, when I saw everything around me and I saw my kids looking at me sitting at home and not going to work, asking their mother, why does dad always sit at home? You know, that just snapped something in me, you know, and I just decided from that day that I have to be positive, I have to be persistent. And the most important thing, have faith in myself. So I have so much faith in myself.
During that lull phase, Bobby, did you have an alternate craft or alternate business model you could fall back upon?
I had nothing.
What was a model of sustenance then?
I had nothing. I went the wrong way. I took support of, I've said it in so many of my interviews, you know. I just don't feel like repeating myself all the time. But yeah, I took support of things which will calm me down, which will take away the pain. And I never thought of anything else, because as I was growing up, I always wanted to be an actor. And for me, being a businessman or something else was not my dream. And till date, I can't be a businessman, because we are too... My family, I think, it's just the way we are, you know. None of us are good businessmen. We are actors. And I have two legends in my house, my brother and my dad. So I just need to work every day. And that was my goal. And finally, that's what I'm achieving even today. And And struggle is always going to be a part of our life. All actors go through struggle. I'm sure Aditi would also understand that. And so everybody has their own struggle.
Bobby, while you play this self-styled god man, a con artist, so to speak, in this one. Because here you are in real life, a positive model to look up to as well. So any final advice to the youngsters who may feel a little low during this lockdown? Can serve a message, tell them something really positive.
I always say one thing is that, as I said, have faith in yourself. Have belief. That's the most important thing. And once you have belief in yourself, you will become positive in your way of looking at things. And that will make you more persistent in what you want to achieve. I mean, difficult times teach you what really is important, you know. So I think you learn a lot from difficult times than you learn from your success. Success makes you forget all the miseries and pains.
True.
But once you're down there, it's when you know that I was there, up there, or I was moving in the right direction and I lost it. But you don't lose it. Don't ever give up in life. That's it.
You certainly have not lost it, and you have certainly not given up. The way you are bouncing back is tremendous, is remarkable, and we are so glad to see you.
Thank you so much.
Any final thing that you would want to say? I mean, what challenges did you face in the industry? And how did you cope with them?
Honestly, I've not faced any challenges as such because I'm such a believer. Audition bhi toh ek part hota hai. Achha, ye nahi mila, wo bhi ek part hota hai. I mean, it's a part of life. Toh mujhe challenge aisa kuch laga nahi, honestly speaking. But mujhe aisa hamesha laga ki you should try and excel at what you're doing. That's for sure. Toh usme mere challenges the. Matlab, rehearsals mein challenges the. Hamesha craft mein challenges the. But industry has been so lovely to me. I'm telling you, with Imtiaz sir, me getting my first break in Bollywood with Imtiaz Ali was my dream. You know, I was like, yeah, baby, that's it. It's done. And then it became like this. And I was like, wow. So this is great. And of course, my first break was with Nishikant Kamat. Even that was like a Marathi film. So in the Marathi industry also, it was a very big film, and I was like so excited the way I was welcomed. So mala, manje, I would say challenges were not really the word, not at all.
See, this is exactly the attitude every young actor requires.
Aspiring actor must have.
This is the attitude. This is a perfect attitude.
Thank you so much for your time, Robbie Deol and Aditi. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for this lovely chat on Latestly. Yeah. Thank you. All the best for Ashram.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.